Hello everyone. Welcome to our channel. Information Briefcase. Today we're going to learn about immune against every diseases. Now, let's begin. You are not an individual, you are a mountain, made of about 40 trillion cells. There is such a large amount of you, that if your cells were human-sized, you would be just about as large as 10 Mount Fuji in Japan. For your dreadful hunter occupants, this makes your body an environment, wealthy in assets and warmth and space. An ideal spot to move into, and structure long ages of family. While a portion of these aliens are gladly welcomed, most are not. Your immunity is the watchman of this system, the tactical power utilized in safeguarding yourself against these alien invasion. Unfortunately, your enemies in your little world enjoy a tremendous benefit against you. Think about the process it takes to make a solitary duplicate of yourself and your trillions of cells. First, you want to find somebody who thinks you are acceptable, date that individual, and be awkward, and if your karma work out in support of yourself, two of your cells combine. Then, at that point, you really want to sit tight for a very long time, 10 months, while the cell get cooked again and again. Until it is delivered into the world as a child. And, after it's all said and done, you just have a smaller than expected duplicate of yourself that needs a long time to turn out to be somewhat valuable. A bacteria comprises of one cell. It can make a completely developed duplicate in just 30 minutes. An infectious virus can transform into hundreds in just 1 hour and billions in no time. Your enemy's duplicating time is significantly quicker than you. Far more terrible, for a bacterium or infection, your body is an antagonistic biological system applying particular strain. Since they go through such countless ages so rapidly, at last by pure luck, there will be a person that transforms and adjusts in the perfect manner to oppose your guards, and afterward increase rapidly once more. As such, you are confronting a wide range of enemies and you're too slow to keep up with their evolution and mutation. This is awful. Fortunately, your immunity is just with regards to the most astonishing thing of all time. The second most complex organic framework known to us, after the human mind, so complex that we actually haven't found every nature of it. Since it is so complex, we need to improve and need to subdivide and focus on just one feature. Alright, so for what reason would we say we are not killed by some new microbes or infection? Basically, you really have two immune system, the natural and the versatile invulnerable immunity. The natural immunity was prepared when you were developing as a baby. It for the most part comprises of general foot soldiers. The adaptive immune system conveys two kinds of cells. T cells and B cells, that are your super weapons, and are very powerful and destructive for your enemies. These cells are very complicated to be manufactured, and it's time consuming, so using them is always delayed. However, when they are prepared, they give a significant damage to your enemies. What makes your adaptive immune system so incredible is that it has the biggest library known to mankind. It has a response to everything. You have something like one of these super weapon cells inside you. To battle the dark passing, all types of COVID and the primary destructive bacteria that will arise in a city on Mars in future after 100 years. This makes it workable for you to counter the capacity of bacteria and infections to change so quickly. How can this be? To get what is happening here, we want to make one step back. All living beings on Earth are produced using similar fundamental parts, for the most part proteins. Proteins are the basic structural material of life. It can have billions of various shapes. You can envision them as 3D unique pieces. There are billions of various interconnecting pieces your enemies can use to develop their bodies. For what reason is this significant? Since proteins are in a way the language of the microworld. Cells don't have eyes or ears, so to recognize companion from enemy. They need to touch them and find if their protein is essential for a companion or part of an enemy. Finding them implies that cells have endless little gadgets called receptors that can make contact with a particular protein unique piece. So your cells have small unique pieces on their exterior that can click together or find other protein interconnecting pieces. At the point when a cell interfaces along with a protein and remembers it as enemy, it realizes that it needs to kill it. Provided that your cells can make this qualification between companion or enemy, is your immunity ready to battle a trespasser? Since there are billions of conceivable protein interconnecting pieces, this implies there are billions of conceivable foe interconnecting pieces. This is likewise one reason we actually need to manage sicknesses like seasonal influenza every year. The flu infection transforms quickly, thus the proteins that make up its frame continually change a bit. The warriors of your innate immune system have countless unique pieces. For normal microbes and infections remembered, that is the reason they are your universally handy weapons. Yet, they are incapable against a huge number of transformations and variations that your enemies can create. So the explanation you are alive is that your adaptive immunity can find between 1 billion and 10 billion diverse adversary protein unique pieces, which is sufficient to be ready for each expected enemy. However, how can this be the case? How is it possible that your immunity possibly have this a very remarkable assortment to be ready for each conceivable protein interconnecting piece? Indeed, the cells of your adaptive immune system observed an easy shortcut, blending and coordinating with their own hereditary code to make this staggering assortment of receptors. The complexity of this topic is very confusing for this video. However, basically, your adaptive immune cells have official authorization to take their very own little piece hereditary code and blend it in irregular ways to make billions of various receptors. A decent way of clarifying this is by requesting you to envision a group of cooks, with every one of them needing their own dish. They have 100 unique ingredients to choose and decide. Every ingredient represents one little piece of hereditary code in this illustration. So each cook takes a couple of unplanned ingredients and casually combines them as one. Possibly tomato, mutton, rice and a large portion of garlic as dish, candy, pepper, apple and a quarter peach as a treat. Or on the other hand, cabbage, chicken, radish and two beetroot, what's more, retchery, white chocolate and curd with a little amount of cinnamon. Indeed, even with slight variety, and with just 100 ingredients, there are billions of potential dishes. In the same way, by combining a little gene cells, your cells make billions of receptors. The process of this are entirely cool, to the point that they ought to get a separate article or a video. Regardless, by combining gene materials you get up to 10 billion distinct mixes. So eventually, you get billions of immunity cells, and every one of them has one separate receptor. The dish from our representation, that can remember one unique protein interconnecting piece. Altogether, you end up with something like one cell for each enemy, that might actually exist. But here we come to face a very hazardous issue. If your adaptive immune system is making weapons that can assault each conceivable protein interconnecting piece in the galaxy, wouldn't it additionally make some that can assault your own cells? Indeed, it happens constantly. This is so on a very basic level dangerous to your survival that you have an entire organ that accomplishes only work on preventing this. The homicide school of your thymus. Your thymus is a chicken wing-shaped organ over your heart, and you've most likely never known about it. Curiously, your thymus is one reason why your immunity framework get destroyed as you age, since it is in a steady condition of reduction once you arrive at adolescence. How does the thymus do its work? In your homicide school, your immunity is putting your adaptive immunity cells through an extraordinary and destructive educational syllabus. Essentially, it is showing them a wide range of protein interconnecting pieces that are utilized by your own cells to perceive how they respond. At the point when a youthful cell finds your own body interconnecting piece and needs to assault it, the instructor cells commands them to switch off themselves and they are eaten up and reused. The immunity framework is so specific with regards to this cycle that around 98% of your adaptive immunity cells that enter murder college get murdered there. Only 2% students graduate and join the duty of protecting you without a doubt. If this system turns out badly, and cells get away from that can perceive your own protein interconnecting pieces, this can cause immunity disorder illness, where your immunity framework assaults your own body from within. Alright, let us sum up. Your immunity framework has two sections, one that protects you just after birth and one that conveys the biggest library of superweapons in the galaxy, but it should be able to boot up first. To make billions of various superweapons, your adaptive immunity cells recombine a piece of their hereditary code to make an amazing different kinds of assault weapons. Then, at that point, they enter a homicide school in that simply only 2% survive to ensure they don't assault you. Then, at that point, you end up with billions of various cells that altogether can protect you against each enemy in the universe. Wait a second, if all the process and explanations are correct, for what reason do we become ill? For what reason illness like COVID-19 ready to kill a great number of individuals? Well, all that we just found out about is only a small little window into our immune system functions. We learned about a great battle which goes on forever each day inside your body. What's more, there are such countless stunning details and inquiries here, like, how does your body really observe the right cell and at correct time to safeguard you? How do your enemies retaliate and defeat your immunity framework at any rate? So let's say that a guy has flu. It could be any type of flu. And when he sneezed, the droplets from his nose and mouth contains millions of virus. There are a lot of viruses floating through the air, some of which go inevitably up. It's gonna land on any one of person's throat. The throat cells has interconnecting lock-like membrane on their surface. If the sticky interlocking key-like membrane on the virus surface happens to fit this interconnecting lock membrane, then the virus is welcomed into your body. They interlock with your human cell, and they go down into the cell deeper and deeper. And that structure of the virus disperses and the virus capsule bursts out. It gives out the secret recipe to your human cells and teach how to make more viruses. And those human cells are tricked into guiding these virus recipes right into its own command center, the nucleus. The nucleus is like a mini factory. The nuclear material sends the virus recipe through one hole. And it comes out from another hole as a brand new virus recipe, so it's a copying machine making copy after copy. Copy of virus recipes which then go out of the nucleus to little chefs in our cells. Those things, they cook up proteins that go back into the nucleus, where they are reassembled into baby viruses. And then they get covered up and head to the surface, where they get new keys. And then boom, this is an eruption of virus after virus after virus after only one virus entered the cell. But how many came out? Well, their number are like millions. So if one virus can produce a million babies and do it again and again, how come this guy doesn't just drop dead in like 10 minutes? Because you have about 100 trillion cells, so a million viruses is just a drop in the ocean. When you have 100 trillion cells, you do have your own immunity framework, which when it sees a virus usually kills it. So, even though the virus multiply fast, your immune system will work just a little faster than it, and this racing process create your body temperature to raise, which causes fever. All viruses want to spread, that's what they do, but most of the time we do keep them in check. But in rare cases, if a person's immunity system is low, or if the virus structure is very complex, our immunity framework struggle to understand its complexity, and in that time the virus multiplies in high speed. Our immunity framework can't keep up with virus multiplying speed. This causes death in some individual. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and comment.